Hey guys, thank you so much for your time and thank you so much for joining. And to all my new subscribers, my name is Michelle and today we're going to talk about 5 shopping etiquette tips to help you build a good relationship with your salesperson and to be a better shopper. First things first, don't forget to smash that like and subscribe button if you have been getting helpful tips from me. I love to see your positive comments as well. They really do help to grow the channel. Today, I'm going to give you some ideas just from my perspective as a former sales associate that will help you build a better relationship with your client advisor and help you to understand some of the ins and outs of luxury shopping and may relieve some of your questions about some of the frustration you're feeling about how to shop in luxury retail, why they don't have your things, and blah, blah, blah. I already know that most of my viewers are really good, dedicated, loyal shoppers, and you have great relationships and really appreciate your CAs. And of course, I'm going to address a lot of the questions I've been getting from first-time and new shoppers as well. Tip number one, try to return to the salesperson who is helping you. Now, if you're new and you're extensively looking at a bag for like 20 or 30 minutes or asking that salesperson to bring you numerous items and then you're getting confused and you're thinking a lot and you might just want to step back and really think about what is it you really want. Sometimes you just go to lunch or get a coffee and then you come right back to the store or it may take a few days. Well, see, it's the salesperson's job to show you the pieces and to help you along, so that's no problem as long as you're being nice and courteous and considerate about it. But now when you come back, please, please go back to that same salesperson because it really breaks his or her heart when they see you buying an item that you showed them and you're buying it from someone else. It's kind of a slap in the face, although you may not intend for it to be, but you are giving a different associate the credit when that first associate spent all that time with you. Whether or not they make commission, every retail salesperson has sales goals. So your purchase definitely helps them to make their sales goals. So if they were courteous and kind with you and showing you those items and spent a lot of time suggesting things that helped you make your decision, yes, you should go back to them. Okay, so a question I want to address, a lot of people ask that if a item is purchased through one sales associate and they just need to come in and pick it up and another sales associate hands them the bag, your original sales associate will get the credit. So as long as you complete the sales transaction with the original associate, then that's fine. Your associate will get the credit. Now, if you're going to ask the person who handed you the bag to show you some items, then let them show you some items. But don't say, okay, show me all these things, and then I'm gonna go buy it from the other person. It's only fair that you buy it from the person who showed it to you. Even though the other person is your sales associate, that sales associate most likely will say, let that person have the sale if he or she is the one that helped you look for some other things when you came in to shop. Okay, so that also leads me to point number two, is that a lot of people just come in and say, I already have a sales associate in Beverly Hills, I already have a sales associate in Chicago or whatever, and I just want to come and look at everything here and ask a lot of questions. So I'm not gonna buy anything, but I'm gonna ask you to show me everything and I'm not gonna buy from you. Or they do that and like, I'm just gonna go to Paris and buy there, or I'm just gonna shop online, but I want you to show me everything. So this puts the sales associate in a bind because yeah, it is their job to show you things, but also know that because they're helping you, they're losing valuable time with clients that actually want to buy something on the spot right then and there. So if there is something you want to see, like maybe have a list and make it quick, like one or two things, can I just take a look-see so I can start thinking about it, you know, and maybe that salesperson will actually interest you in other things and start to build a relationship with you. But when you come in like, I'm not gonna buy anything, but I want you to show me this because I have another sales associate, well, we really want to say then go to the other sales associate because it's kind of rude. It's kind of equivalent to this. Now I know not everyone has worked retail, but if you're sitting in your corporate job at your desk and someone just comes along, your friend, your mom, your sister comes and sits at your desk and says, I just want to talk to you for half an hour, you're not busy right now, right? We can just shoot the breeze and let me just interrupt you, or let me call you on the phone and talk to you about my marital problems just for like half an hour. You're not working, you're not busy, right? You're just sitting there, right? That's okay, right? So it's just like that, is that we don't go, like, a sales associate doesn't go into your office and just, "Hi, I just want to interrupt your time. Oh, you could be doing something else. You have a $1 million deal in the work. I know, but just let me talk." It's just like that. Okay, we're not like hanging out at the store. We're not hanging out just playing with Louis Vuitton. Number three, there is a right way to complain. Okay, so everyone has the right to complain. If something is, if you're really unhappy with something, go back to the store. Now, what you should not do is slam your items on the counter and say, "I don't like this, I need to return it," and get all hissy. First of all, the sales associate, they're trained to want to rectify your problem, as long as it's legit and within reason. So we want to hear your story. Let us hear your story rather than shouting it at us. There's that saying, you attract more flies with honey than with vinegar. If it's a quality defect or if you just want to turn it, like, there's no need to come in angry. Think of it this way, like, you're starting a negotiation. So let me just give you an example. If it really is something you feel like is a quality issue, like if you bought a wallet and maybe the glazing is falling apart. So I'm gonna give you an example. "Hi, thank you so much for seeing me. I just wanted you to look at this item and I was wondering if there's anything you can do to help me. I bought this wallet 3 months ago or so and I noticed that this seam is falling apart and I thought it was a little unusual. Could you take a look at it? Is there anything you can do to help me?" It's inquisitive, it's polite, it's open, and it's non-accusatory. It makes the salesperson like, "Oh, okay, this person wants to cooperate. And you're not coming at me like, this wallet is bad." We don't know what to do with that. And then it kind of makes someone not likely to want to work with you in that case, because it might just be like, "Okay, yeah, we agree with you." Most of the times the client gets what they want, whether it's an exchange, a return, or repair. And some of those that get what they want, they leave angry anyways. We saw it a lot of times where it was like, "Well, they got what they wanted anyways. Why are they still angry?" And I did mention on the video, like, some people just come in with attitude and they're just always angry. So anyways, if you do want those special items, if you want your client advisor to contact you or let you know when those special items are coming in or for events, like, those types of attitudes are not relationship building if you're coming in already like screaming and wanting to throw something at us. Because, you know, like I said, we want to help. The salesperson wants to rectify the situation within reason. Now, if you're coming in like, "My bag charm got scratched, my sunglasses got scratched, and it's your fault," then it's normal wear and tear. There is nothing that anyone can do about that. Just because it's Vuitton does not mean that it's stainless steel or bulletproof. So see my video about how to take care of your items and what not to do. Item number four, please do not molest the product in the store and then ask for a new one. There are a lot of questions about this too. There are no floor models. The only place with floor models is Best Buy or Target. Think of this as like you're going to the Mercedes dealership. You see a car that you want. You test drive it. You sit in the driver's seat. You sit in the back seat. You smell the seats. You open the trunk. You touch everything. But would you say, "Okay, I like this. Give me a new one from the back"? Like, there's no back. There's no car in the back of a Mercedes dealership. You take the one that you're romancing. So a lot of people completely touch everything, they romance this bag, they put it on every part of their body, they put their credit cards inside, they take them out, they put everything they have in the bag, and they romance this bag, and then they tease it and they don't take it home. Or sometimes they just say, "Well, I don't want this one. People have been touching it. I want a new one." And we're like, "Sir or ma'am, you're the only one who's molested this bag today. You know, you've already touched this bag. And maybe the next customer saw you doing that, so now they don't want it anymore." Well, they say they want a new one from the back. Okay, there is no back. There's no back. Now, sometimes in the flagship stores, they do have merchandise in the back of the popular bags, but the popular bags, they rotate so quickly, within hours. So if it's newly on the floor, it is newly out the door, and the next one comes in. So I'm not lying when I say if you get a bag that they open the drawer and pull that bag probably came in that morning or hasn't been there for more than a few days. I'm gonna give you an example of the wallet drawer because a lot of people will come look at the wallet and then they want a new one. And I'm like, this is the drawer and this is where the wallets are. There's nothing in the back. Like, these are all new. This is the process. The product comes in a brown box and we open the box and the wallet comes inside the dust bag. No plastic wrap, okay? We separate the dust bag from the wallet. We open the wallet, take all the cardboard out, and throw that away. And then we put the wallet in the wallet drawer. So that's, and then we hand it to you. That's the whole process. So a lot of people, I think when they ask this, they're expecting like this brand new shrink wrap wallet from Vuitton, and that's not gonna happen because the merchandise doesn't even come in that way. It literally comes in the store and we put it in that drawer right away. Think of how it would just cheapen the feel of the brand and the store if everything was plastic wrapped. Now that same process goes for handbags. We open the dust bag, take off all the plastic and anything that is covering the hardware, the handles, any of those things, the foam, they get thrown away and the bag goes back in the dust bag and goes in a drawer. For those of you who want a new one, there's nothing that's like plastic shrunk wrap for you. Also, these products, they're not like in stock like Target. We might get one or two or three in, and three could be max at a smaller store. So it rotates very quickly. It's likely that the one that you're looking at is a new one that just came in. Now about the displays, do not be afraid to purchase the merchandise that's on display because as quickly as things move, someone might just have put a bag on the shelf or it might have gone there that morning and someone sold it, so they put another one on there. The salesperson's job is also to keep the visuals looking perfect and the shelves dusted every day, and they give us strict guidelines and photos to follow about how the merchandise on the shelf should look. So it's not like it's been sitting there collecting dust or that it's like the floor model, because like I said, there's no floor model. So literally everything there is new. That's how quickly that the things rotate through the store. Okay, so don't be afraid to buy the products on the shelves. I totally understand because I would rather have one that's like, do you have one that has not been looked at and untouched because you're spending a lot of money. But if they don't, if that product that is on the shelf, if it looks good to you and there's no defects, nothing's wrong, like don't be afraid to take it home. Now also, people will look at the thing and then go, I want a new one. Can you order me a new one? And I don't know where this myth comes from that they think they're ordering direct from the factory. I've seen those comments too where people say like, oh yeah, I ordered it direct from the factory, and no. It's not a factory to order. There's no little man waiting for orders. When you want a new one or we put in an order, sometimes, yeah, you will get one that comes nicely wrapped up from the distributor. And a lot of times, especially if it's a very limited item, it's gonna be plucked from another store. And we don't know the condition of that. So it's sometimes better if you see that item you like in the store and you just want to order a new one because you think you're getting a new one, it could just be plucked from another store. Someone molested that in another store, who knows? Or it could be coming in perfect from that other store. I don't know, but I just want to dispel the myth that you think by ordering one that you're getting like a brand new made from the factory, because no, they are not made to order, sorry. Now lastly, my tip number 5, accept the answer. Accept the answer. There are times to question if you really feel it's like a quality issue, but like I said, sales associates already know that and they will do their best to try to help you. But luxury retail is luxury and exclusive. They want to remain exclusive. It's not like Nike where they serve different tiers of customers, because Nike serves Kohl's, Nordstrom's, and then they have their exclusives for the sneakerheads. And they're all different price points, but they want everyone to be wearing that Nike logo. Vuitton, Chanel, Hermes, it's very different. They don't want everybody to be wearing their logo. They do, but they don't. What I mean by that is don't expect every product to be readily available. This is luxury. Their items are made in limited amounts to prevent everyone from having them. If everyone had them, it wouldn't be special anymore. And then they could not justify the huge price tag that they put on their items if it is accessible to all the masses. I'm gonna give you another example, like what I say about Nike. I one time had this customer that he asked about the shoes, and the shoes for the smaller boutiques, you get one size run, meaning there's no multiple size 7s, there's no multiple size 10s, there's one size run. So you have to tell the customer, if you want this shoe, buy it now. Because the shoes are so popular, especially for the men, that if it's gone, it's gone. So it's telling a customer this, and he said, that's okay, you can just order me one from the warehouse. I was like, no, there's no warehouse. This isn't like Nike. It's Vuitton, it's exclusive, they make one size run, and the flagship stores might have more. But again, oh, I'll just order it. People think they're ordering this from the warehouse. No one has tried it on, that's great. No, they are gonna pluck it from the closest store that has that size. So someone else's feet might have been in them to try them on, or might have been returned, or could be brand new. But they're not, this is not like stock on demand type of thing. Okay, so like I said, like most people who do seriously shop Vuitton know this, that sold out is sold out. Not available means not available. And Vuitton has no interest in making more just to keep up with the demand. They're actually doing quite the opposite. You all know about the toiletry pouches. They've just pulled them from the website, and they don't even tell the salespeople this. They pretty much just cut you guys off because they got so popular on social media that everybody wanted to have this toiletry pouch. When they see that something is becoming something that everybody wants, and they're making this into like crossbody bags, and that's not the purpose of the bag. Of course, the brand wants to protect themselves by like, hey, let's just pull it. And we're not gonna worry about that $500 item because there's all these other people buying the $2,000 items and the $3,000 items. So they are not in the game to please you just because you want that toiletry pouch. So another comment I see is like shortages. Like no, there's no shortages. They've never been interested in supplying something for the masses. Think about brands like Supreme. Like they make very limited quantity and it makes people want them more. So that's the name of the game when you're shopping luxury. Okay, so as I was saying, like sold out is sold out. No matter how much you spend or whine or cry, like nobody can make an item just reappear. It's gonna be okay too, because if you don't get the item that you want, there is going to be another bag. And sometimes it's just not meant to be. You're not meant to spend your money on that particular item at that point. So that's okay. I'm like, all right, well, I'm not meant to spend that money. There's gonna be something better. So don't worry about it. Don't stress over it. So if you're to this part of the video, guys, thank you so much for watching. Again, this is like my opinion and my commentary as being a former sales advisor. These are just simple etiquette tips to practice, especially if you're hoping to build a better relationship with any store or sales associate. I also know that like a lot of people experience attitude from sales associates. I know that it is hard to get good service sometimes as well. So I understand that from the customer point of view. And my advice there is like, if you don't like the sales associate, you can always just try another one until you find one that like jives with you. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, especially if I've given you some helpful information, and leave a positive comment. It really does help to grow my channel. My name is Michelle. Thank you so much. Bye.